literally 10 degrees out right now.
What's up, vlog? I wish you were here, outside of the bullshit, outside of the 5G Wi-Fi towers and polluted air. I wish you could enjoy the fresh air, the oxygen, the freedom. Ask yourself why you're not here, why you can't live this life. I wish you were here. It'd be fun. Pigeonhole, I'm a night owl, this a different mode. I'ma have to make a paint of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard, just let a nigga know. I would have your court side, not the middle row. Ladies and gentlemen, we're in beautiful Breckenridge. Welcome to another vlog. What I was thinking about today is the fact that it's Tuesday, the week has just started, and the peasants have just clocked in. On the other side of the matrix, there is a kid in his mid-20s that rents out a $10,000 a week mansion, top of the mountain, with his buddies, with his friends. While I'm no different than you are, I get to experience life in a completely different way, and the thing is, I may just know something that you don't. The information that you have has given you the life that you have, and if the life that you have is not a life that you enjoy, it probably is the information that you were fed since the moment you were born. From the moment you were born, you were given a name, you were given an identity, you were given a religion, you were given a social security number, you were given national anthem, you were given colors, you were given preferences, you were given all these things that constructed who you are today, and it's those things that you have to deconstruct if you want to live life on your own terms. You're living the life of the system because you are conditioned by the system, so if you want to live a different life, you want to enjoy the beauty of the matrix, you want to enjoy exploring the quest and exploring the map, you have to learn exploring, taking information from other places that are going to elevate you and allow you to achieve your fullest potential. Why limit yourself to a cubicle, to some fluorescent lights and some Excel sheets working for a boss that'll never, ever, ever give a damn about you, that'll replace you within 72 hours after you quit or after you die? He doesn't care. You're just a human resource. The department says it itself, right? So figure out who you're listening to, figure out what type of life you want to live, and if the life that you have is not the life that you want to have, then chances are the information that you're feeding here, that you're feeding here, that you're feeding through here, that you're feeding through here, ain't cutting it. Take responsibility, take ownership for your life, and if you're not here with us, what are you doing? Get your shit together, brother. I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Cocaine quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. I got hustle, though, ambition, flow inside my DNA. I was born like this, this born like this, immaculate conception. I transform like this, perform like this. Bro, but here's the thing, what do you think? Like, but if you could weigh utopian versus dystopian outcome, what do you think, bro?
Oh,
dystopian, like no doubt, but yeah. You just go straight to the extreme.
You don't slowly go into it. You're like fuck it.
That's what works in social media, no nuance.
No, I guess.
And I just
true.
Love it, and it's so entertaining to me. But we like agree, all of our foundational principles, what it takes to be successful in general, anything, spot on.
Yeah, no,
but then you get the hot takes, I just start.
It's the hot takes, brother, it's the hot takes. They're just perspectives, bro. I could be totally wrong.
I'm just a big
For all you know, Carl Schwab's wants you eating steak and living in a big ass house, even though he said otherwise, but what do I know?
It's very interesting, because as I stand here, enjoying the sun in the middle of this white paradise, some words come to my mind, and the words are, don't go outside, you'll get cold, you'll get sick, you'll get the flu. And honestly, I've realized after not being sick for so many years that a lot of it has to do with how you program your body, right? If you program your body, being able to enjoy something like this, being out in the cold and not getting sick, but actually being able to boost your testosterone, boost your energy levels, right? It's almost like you are defying the matrix, because the matrix tells you, hey, don't go outside because you'll get sick. And that's true if your body isn't ready, right? And if you have a poor immune system and it's not robust, then yes, the likelihood of you getting sick is very much probable. So we're out here basking in the snow, enjoying the cold weather, boosting testosterone, increasing our energy levels, and adapting ourselves to any environment, right? Cold, heat, take me to the rainforest, take me to the jungle, take me to the mountain, take me to the desert. As a human being and as a glitch, you wanna weaponize yourself and you wanna be able to adapt in any environment. If you need to take your shirt off, enjoy the cold, boost that testosterone, boost that metabolism, do it. Unless you have a poor system, then stay with NPCs, drinking your Mountain Dew, playing your Call of Duty inside next to the fire. I'll be out here on the top of the mountain waiting for you.
Going so fast, we descended 1,400 feet on the mountain, and it was like two and a half something miles in 2 minutes and like 50 seconds. 1,400 feet in 2 minutes and 50 seconds, just carving the whole time.
Look at this. Are you guys going tomorrow?
We already bought your day pass. Day pass? What the fuck? $200 for a day pass? What the fuck is this shit, dude? It's a scam.
You won't lose me on the mountain.
Hey, Woody.
Woody, cut to the slopes, bro. Cut to the slopes. Life is very much like snowboarding. You can't fake it. In life, you're gonna have to go down mountain. You're gonna have to swerve. You're gonna have to go through situations. You can't fake it. You can be a phony, you can buy all the gear, you can buy the goggles, the nice helmet, the expensive shit, but unless you put in the hours, the practice, you cannot master the mountain. Just like life, you have to put in the hours, you have to be willing to fall, get hurt, beat up, and get up, up, over and over and over again until you master the mountain. What are the mountains in your life, motherfucker? All I know is this shit's very much like life. And winners win and losers lose. If you make it down to the fucking slope, continue practicing, training, training, training. In life, you gotta practice, you gotta train, you gotta get beat up, you gotta put in the hours. If not, the mountain will eat you up. You can learn from everything. Perspicacity. Let's fucking go.
Great millionaires are at the Darab. In this room, one, two,
four millionaires in this room.
People always start talking about weather for some reason.
How it became like the universal conversation starter.
Let's get one more.
Nah,
I'll let you win, bro.
Oh, I let you win.
I felt bad. He's filming, bro.
I feel like imposter syndrome often comes in life, regardless of the size of the goal, whether it's small, like getting in the snow, or something big, like making $1 million. If you set a goal and you don't accomplish it, when you hit the bed at night, at a subconscious level, even at a conscious level, you're gonna feel like an imposter. Why? Because, for example, today I decided I had to do my hot and cold therapy like I always do, which usually consists of a hot and cold shower. I decided I'm gonna apply the same therapy, but use the snow in the hot tub instead of hot water and cold water. So this is the power of mind over body. If you can tap into this, right? If you can tap into doing something that you don't want to do with your body, right? Because it's uncomfortable, like getting in the snow. I set my goal, regardless of how small it is, 10 seconds, 1 minute. If I say I'm going to do something, so hypothetically speaking, I said, you're going to get in the cold snow for 10 seconds. 10 seconds may seem small to you, but 10 seconds compounds. What I just did right there, regardless of how small it is, even if it's 10 seconds, I decided I was going to commit to something that was very difficult, like exposing myself to the cold. And I yield two rewards now. The benefit of cold exposure, which increases longevity, boosts energy and testosterone. But that is the internal satisfaction I get because I'm a man of my word. I said I was going to do something and I committed to it. Even if it was 10 seconds, the principle is commit to something, stick to it, and execute. And if the body feels weak and you'll feel like doing it, let the mind be strong. And if the mind is weak, let the body be strong. By the end of the day, bro, if you want to get rid of imposter syndrome, set up some challenging goals that are going to be beneficial for you and execute on them. And at night, when you're sleeping on that pillow, you're going to feel like a total G because you committed to what you said you were going to do. Yeah, drinking dope, turn me to a superhero. Yeah, hit that pill, turn me to a superhero. Yeah, boom, my 90s, turn me to a superhero. Metro, don't trust you. I want to teach you an extremely important principle, a principle that had I learned long before I did, I would have tenfold my net worth, I would have tenfold my relationships, I would have tenfold my access to deal flow, and I would have tenfold my ability to put myself in the right rooms to succeed. And that principle is the power of positioning. There is power in how you position yourself. Now, many times people talk about hustling, grinding, working hard, you know, waking up, working 19-hour days as the ingredient for success. If that was the case, then the construction workers or the plumbers or the garbage men, those would be the wealthiest people. But the reality is, hard work alone, hustle alone, does not equate to success. Why is it that all these trust fund kids, why is it that all these sons of bankers and daughters of bankers or financiers, how is it that they get access to deal flows, access to IPOing companies and seed rounds and really good investment vehicles, and you don't? Are they any more intelligent than you? Well, potentially yes, but I could debate that the power and the position that they have gives them access to multiply at a faster rate than the average man, than the average woman. So the question is, in your career, how have you positioned yourself to win? Or are you always constantly hustling
and trying to find your ability to make a quick buck, or thinking that working hours equates to productivity. I know a lot of motherfuckers that work a lot and produce nothing. Practice, train, so that when the opportunity comes, through your positioning, you can actually deliver. You can actually follow through. You can win. You can succeed. Power is in positioning. How are you positioned?
Fuck a pigeonhole, I'm a night out, it's a different mode. I'ma have to make a paint of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard.